anywhere in the world in 18 hours and whatever the nation needs.
Loss on the battlefield is expected.
And you're doing what the 82nd does.
But far from the front lines, it's what you don't see.
You understand what everybody's going through.
The things you don't always expect.
Everyone goes through something.
That threatens a soldier's safety.
Even though you're in the 82nd Airborne Division, every day is not perfect.
So far this year, the 82nd Airborne Division in Fort Bragg, North Carolina, has lost 10 paratroopers to suicide. The number stood at 4 in 2019. The increase has pushed Major General Christopher Donahue to make suicide prevention and mental health outreach a priority within his ranks.
Nobody wants to talk about this in everyday life, but we have to make it the norm.
You kind of get dull to it, I guess, is the way to put it.
In August, just days after graduating second in his class from a U.S. Army leadership course, Staff Sergeant Jason Lowe took his own life inside his Fayetteville, North Carolina apartment. Staff Sergeant Ryan Graves found him.
Everything they teach you that you're supposed to look for doesn't exist in that kind of situation. Like no financial trouble, no relationship trouble.
And I think that's what eats you alive the most as a leader, as a friend. There was never a sign.
The coronavirus pandemic has been especially isolating for soldiers and is raising concern. Many return from overseas deployments to mandatory quarantines.
Immediately coming off the plane, no ceremony, going straight into quarantine.
Visits to family and friends out of state were also put on hold.
The way I describe it is COVID has made us a division of strangers, okay? And we're doing everything in our power to bring everybody back together.
Suicide is one of the leading causes of death in the United States. The most recent data from the Department of Defense shows the number of suicide deaths among active duty service members increased between 2013 and 2018. Most service members were enlisted men under 30 years old.
You consider every decision you make and the impact on 630 heartbeats that are in your formation.
The 82nd Airborne Division is now creating support groups, sober living barracks, and working to train leaders to better help struggling soldiers.
Is enough being done?
We have to lead the nation. The military has to lead the nation in figuring this out.
Since Lowe's death, chaplains have seen more soldiers seeking their help.
How do you get after this invisible enemy that you don't know people are going through?
Finding solutions for a hidden pain and hoping to save lives one soldier at a time. Sarah Blake Morgan, The Associated Press.